your girl Becky G, and you are watching Pavlina's Kids Place.
Hey guys, it's Pavlina from Pavlina's Kids Place, and I am here on location at Universal Studios Orlando, and I am here with the main attraction, Becky G. How are you doing?
I'm good. It's really hot, but I'm happy to be here.
Yes, same. It's crazy. Oh my gosh. So have you had a good time, and like, are you going to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter?
Yes, I am. I'm so excited. It's my first time here ever, so I'm pretty stoked, and the fact that I also get to perform too in front of all my fans is also really special, so. Yeah.
Definitely. Do you have like a favorite ride that you're excited to see?
I don't know. I'm all about roller coasters, so I guess we'll see how I handle all the roller coasters here. Yeah.
Go to Harry Potter World. You have to try the butterbeer.
Everybody's telling me about the butterbeer. They're like, it's so good. You have to have it, but I hear you can't have too much of it, especially before I go on stage. So maybe like all of me and my dancers will try it, but we won't go too hard on the butterbeer.
Yeah, maybe after the performance or something. I don't know. We'll have to see. What makes your music so different? And like, because there's like 60 million on YouTube, like 134 million on Spotify. Like, tell me about it.
It's crazy. I feel really lucky that the fans have received my music the way they have. You know, for me, I just make music because I love it. And to see that music is really like universal and everybody listens to it, whether they speak the same language or not, they all connect to it in different ways. And I feel like with my music, what makes it different is that it's me being myself. I grew up in Inglewood, so I got a little bit of that hood urban vibe, but at the same time I also grew up listening to pop music. So I do a nice combo of urban mixed with pop, and I'm also Latina, so I mix a little bit of that Latin flavor in there.
Definitely. And actually, in some of your music videos I've seen like the dancers with like the classic Hispanic. Can you tell me a little about that? Are you like proud of your heritage and everything?
Very proud of my heritage. I mean, it's in my blood, it's in my everyday life. You know, I cook the Mexican food with my grandma's, I watch the novelas with my mom and my little sister, and I listen to the music, so yeah.
What is like a biggest fashion dilemma for you? Because obviously you're very like stylish, cute and everything.
Fashion dilemma. I mean, I think that the worst thing that somebody could do is not have confidence in something that they're wearing. For sure, because like there's been times where I go to the grocery store and I'm like maybe wearing a onesie, but I am rocking that onesie, okay? Yeah. So the biggest dilemma you can have is if you're not confident and comfortable in what you're wearing. So I think that's important.
That's perfect. Oh my gosh, it's so true. I always have trouble with my Doc Martens. I'm like,
they're heavy.
Yeah, they are.
They're so heavy. I tried performing in Doc Martens before and it was like dancing with bricks on my feet.
Oh my gosh. Yes, I could totally see that. So what is something that you're like the most scared of?
Something that I'm the most scared of? I don't know. I'm a people's person. I love making friends and I'm all about my fans and I love them so much. And I think my biggest fear is like letting them down, honestly. Like, I've been working so hard on this album and like taking so much time writing and performing and just like overall working really hard on what I'm doing. And I just want to make sure that I'm delivering the best of myself that I can. And I'm really happy with my work and I know the fans are too, but my biggest fear is like one day ever letting them down. So I strive not to.
For example, you have like the perfect date tomorrow with either like whatever, like the perfect date tomorrow, and then your manager calls and say you have to go to the recording studio. Which one would you choose?
The recording studio, because whoever I am going on a date with needs to respect that. Yeah. My career has always been there. It's like music is the one thing that's always been there for me besides my family. Yeah. And this is like my dream, and nothing comes before myself. You know, it's important. So I think, I would definitely choose a studio. Maybe I would just bring them, may have the date in the studio, you know?
There you go. That would be so fun. Yeah. Okay. What is it like with traveling with your family?
Traveling with my family is an honor. I mean, it's so special for me. Like, my DJ is my cousin. Yes. He's my first cousin. He's like my big brother. Mm-hmm. And the truth is that, like, growing up, we were always, like, entertaining our whole family. Yeah. And we were the ones in the living room, like, performing in front of the TV, you know? And now we get to do it on a whole other level where, like, he's always been my backup. And, like, back then it was, like, just me and Freddie. And then now it's, like, I can turn around in front of 40,000 people and Freddie's still there.
Aww.
So, he goes by DJ Osmo, and Osmo's, he's awesome, so.
That's awesome. Thank you so much for talking.
Thank you. No, it was an honor. Can you tell that you drive me crazy? Because I can't get you out of my mind. Think of you when I'm going.